Hello everyone, welcome you all. So in this video I'm going to explain about conditional commands in Selenium WebDriver using Python. So what is the conditional commands and where we need to use these commands? So when you are automating your web pages and we need to verify certain elements are displayed on the page or not, or those elements are enabled or not, or some like checkboxes or radio buttons are selected or not. If you want to verify those statuses of the particular those kind of elements, we need to go and use conditional commands. And especially is enabled as is displayed. So these two commands can be used for any kind of web elements, whereas is selected method can be used for checkboxes and radio buttons. Okay. Now let us see how we can use these three commands practically. So let me open PyCharm. So here I'm going to create a new Python file. I will name it as a conditional commands. Okay, now here first of all I need to import all the packages from Selenium WebDriver. So from Selenium import a WebDriver, from Selenium import WebDriver, and then from Selenium dot WebDriver dot common dot keys also we need to import keys, import keys. And then I will create the driver object. So let's say driver is equal to WebDriver. Driver is equal to WebDriver dot a Chrome. And here we need to specify executable path. So executable underscore path is equal to in the single quotation, double quotations. We need to specify the path of the driver. So I'll provide the path of my Chrome driver. And then, so this is a creation of the driver. So we have to use one single package. Now I have created the driver object. Now I'll open a URL of the web page. Let's say driver.get, and in the double quotations, I will specify URL of Mercury Tools application. And then as soon as you open the page, so I will get to, I will see two different elements, username and password text box, right? So I'm opening my application. So here you can see username and password fields are displayed. Now, as soon as a page is landed, I need to verify whether the username text box is displayed or not. Okay, I want to verify whether username text box is displayed or not, and also it is enabled or not. I want to get the status of these input boxes, displayed or not, or enabled or not. So basically, the conditional commands will return always a Boolean value. That means either true or false, right? So now here, I want to verify this particular input box is enabled or not and displayed or not and then enabled or not. So how we can do that? So first we need to identify this element. So let's inspect this element, and here I have a name property. So let's capture the name of the element called username, and based on that I'm trying to identify this element. So how to identify this element? Driver dot find element, driver dot find element by name, and here I can specify the name, and this will identify the element. As soon as I identify the element, I will store that element in a variable, let's say ELE. So now I will verify whether this element is displayed or not and enabled or not. So ELE dot, the method is displayed, and this method will return either true or false. If it is a displayed, it returns true. If it is not displayed, it returns false. So we have to print that value, so using print command. Now what this will do, it displays or it checks or it returns true or false based on element status. If it is enabled, it will return true. If it is not enabled, it returns false. So is displayed or not. And then similarly, I will find out whether the same element is enabled or not. Is enabled is another method. And this will also return either true or false. You can print that value. Okay, so here it returns either true or false based upon the status of the element. Okay, now till now, let me just run this code, just run this conditional statement. Now it is giving something wrong here. Okay, so we did a mistake here. This is a uppercase letter, so it's a keys. Okay, let's run this again one more time. So now it's launching the Chrome browser. Now it's verifying. Yes, now it is username is verified. So both the statement are returns true. That means is displayed is true and is enabled is also true. So this element is displayed as well as enabled. Now I'll log into the application and then I will verify the status of the radio button by using isSelected method, right? So here we have seen is displayed and is enabled or not. Now I'm logging into the application. So first let me enter the username. So username we already identified in the element, right? So similarly, you can also verify the status of password if you want. So you can verify this password also. Driver.findElement. You can capture the attribute of this password element. Maximize and inspect this password element and capture the name again. Name is a password and go here. PyChamp. Now driver.findElementByName. And specify the name of the password element, and if you want to store this, you can store this element, right? So now we can print the status again. So I'm copying the same stuff again. So whatever the old value we have in this element, this will be removed, it will be gone, or else we can specify, this is called username element, right? I can say user_ELE. I'll just rename this variable names to differentiate this, and this is called pwd_element, password element, and here I will use it. All right, now we are also verifying the status of the password element, is it displayed or enabled. Now let us run this code, run as conditional commands. Now it's launching the page, entering the username, and now entering the password. So we haven't entered anything, right? So far, so we have just verified the status of those elements. So if you observe here, it's printed four, all are true. That means username is displayed, username is enabled, password field also displayed, password is also enabled, right? Now what I will do is, after checking these two statuses, here I will enter the username on this particular user element. Or else you can enter after validation also. You can just take username element, okay, dot, we have to use a send keys is a method, send keys. And here I will pass a username as Mercury, and for password element I will pass dot send keys, or here also I will pass Mercury. All right, now username entered, password entered. So what's the next thing? We need to click on the sign in button. Now identify the sign in button. So here this is a sign in button identified, and capture the name is available, capture the name again. Go here and identify this element, driver dot find element by name, and specify the name dot, we have to use a click button, click action, right? So once we click on the login, it will login into the application. Now let me login into the application manually. I'll say Mercury, and then I'll say Mercury and click on the sign in. So once you login into the application, so I've given wrong input. Let me give Mercury and Mercury. Now click on the sign in. So it will log in into the application. So once you log in into the application, we can see the flight finder page. Here we can select either round trip and one way. So by default, when you land this particular page, by default the round trip radio button is selected. Right? Round trip radio button is selected. So I need to verify whether the round trip button is selected or not. So the status of the radio button I want to verify. So how we can verify this? By using isSelected method. And before that, we need to identify this element. So how to identify this element? Let's inspect this element, and now let's check what are the attributes we have. So we have a name attribute, round trip type we have, value is equal to round trip we have. And if you observe this another radio button, the type is same again, name is also same. Value is little different. So in this case, we can go and use a CSS selector using class and again attribute combination. So what is the attribute here? What is the different attribute we have? Type is same, name is same, and the value is different. So value, I can use an attribute type. So I can use CSS selector to identify the round trip. Now let me write CSS selector. So how to identify the radio button? Driver dot find element by CSS selector. This is the method I have to use. Find element by CSS selector in the double quotations. I will write CSS selector. So what is the tag name of this? Input is a tag name. So input, and in the square brackets, I need to specify the a unique attribute, that is a value. So value is round trip, here value is a one way. So let me just copy the value round trip. Now specify here. So value is equal to round trip, and don't use any double quotation inside the CSS selector. All right, so this particular element is focusing on the round trip radio button. Now if you want to store that in a variable, I can store. So let's say round trip underscore radio. So this is the element. Now I want to verify the status of this element, whether it's selected or not. So round trip underscore radio dot is, you can verify the enabled, disabled, everything. Okay. And now especially is selected is only for this particular element. So is selected. Again, this will return the status of this element, whether it's selected or not. So by default, it is selected, right? So once you log in successful, this is selected. So we can print that value. So let me just go to PyCharm. Once it is selected, I can put this value in print command. Or else we can store the status in some other variable and we can print it. So now this command will print status of radio button. What is that one? Round trip radio button. And similarly, if I want to find out the status of other button, that is a one way radio button. So again, we can inspect this element and we can have value is a one way, right? So the same I can write again. So identify this element again. This is a one trip. This is a one trip. Let me remove this. This is our one trip radio button, and here input value is changed. So what is the value we have here? Again, one more time, inspect this element. Here the value is one way. Capture this and specify here. Now this CSS selector will identify the one way radio button, and now we can verify the status of this. Now copy this element dot is selected. This will print the status of the second radio button. Print one step radio is selected or not. Okay, so if you want to write a meaningful message, you can write it here. Status of so round trip radio button. Okay, and append and operator is comma in Python. So comma is a separate. Okay, and then we need to again close this. Okay, so here we have additionally add double quotations not required. So here we can use double quotations. So the message we can print in the double quotations, but this value we should not add in the double quotations. Now it is perfectly right. Now similarly here also I will write some message. So this is the status, right? So this is the status of one way radio button. One way radio button, I can say. Remove the quotations. One trip radio button is selected or not. Okay, so that's it. So now it will print the status of the second radio button. Now let us run this code. Now it's launching the browser. It opens the URL. It is entering the username and password. Click on the sign in button, and then it will landing to the flight finder. Now we can find the statuses here. So now we can see status of the round trip radio button is true because it is already selected. Now the status of one way radio button is false because it is not selected. Okay, so these are all conditional commands. So especially is displayed and is enabled commands we can use for any element in the web pages. And the is selected method can be used checkboxes and radio buttons. Sometimes we can also use for drop down boxes. Okay, so these are called as a conditional commands in WebDriver using Python. So that's all for this video. So thank you all for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel to get more updates on this. Thank you all.